take it easy. Good to have me on your side. I ain't saying that you need me. Hey guys, so in case you're new to my channel, I'm Sonjo. I'm a Cameroonian living and working in Belgium, and I'm also married to a Belgian, and we have a baby. He's 4 months old. I wanted to say a newborn, but of course he's not a newborn anymore. He's 4 months old, so he's definitely changed our life. And as a new mom, I'm learning in the process, and I'm sharing what I'm learning with you guys. So if you definitely have some other things, other ideas that you want to share with me, definitely leave them on the comment section. And yeah, definitely guys, welcome back to Everything Interracial. As you can see, I'm again in my son's room. I'm in Noah's room to film another video. This time around, I'm filming my baby must-haves. So the must-haves, the things and gadgets that I've been using with Noah, and just products that I've been using with Noah that I think I should share with you guys, you know. Some of the things I've really been loving, some of the things, you know. Anyway, I call them must-haves because they are a must-have. So, if you're interested in seeing the baby gadgets that I've been using, like baby gadgets that I consider must-haves from 0 to 6 months, then keep on watching. So, as usual, I'm gonna start with the small things and then move on to the bigger things. So, first thing on the list is this manicure pedicure set or a kit for babies. Honestly, I think this is a very, very important item. I think one of the first things you should put on your list because it is so handy. You'll be surprised how long the nails of your baby will be when the baby will be delivered. Honestly, I was surprised, and this thing comes in so handy. Though at that moment the babies are so fragile and soft, and you might be panicking that you might hurt your baby with the kit set or with the nail clipper, but trust me, it won't hurt the baby. It's really made for babies. If you can look at the scissors, it curls. It kind of curves in a way that protects, that prevents you from hurting the baby. So I'll definitely secure myself a manicure, pedicure, nail kit for babies, or just some nail clippers for babies. You know, this one is from the brand Baby Jew, and I really love it. Noah is 18 weeks old now, and I have to cut his nails every other day. Like, they grow like crazy. Otherwise, I have scars on my boobs because when he's breastfeeding, he just likes to touch and just like to, you know, like babies just want to touch. And then sometimes on his face, you know, you have like bruises and scratches all over. So to prevent that, definitely get yourself a manicure pedicure kit for babies. I don't know, this Baby Jew is a European brand, so I don't know if you can find it in the US or in the UK, but I'm sure you can definitely find yourself any nail clipper for babies. So that's my number one item on my must-haves for babies. The second item I want to talk about is the Aquaphor. That's like the ointment, the healing Aquaphor healing ointment. This is what I've been using on his poop to prevent diaper rashes, and I'm so glad with the product because Noah is almost 5 months now, and we have never had any problems with him having diaper rashes or all of or anything of that sort. So his poop has been clear, you know, the whole time thanks to this Aquaphor. So definitely secure yourself one. It's just like a Vaseline, you know. It has no smell. It's fragrance free. So this is really, really a good product. I would recommend it. Get yourself one of these if you want your baby to have that smooth ass, no diaper rashes. And, you know, because sometimes the diaper rashes can really get out of hand and they can really be bad. That's what I'll say. So this has really been helping me a lot. So this is definitely my must have for babies, item number two. And Noah started going to the daycare when he was 3 months old. At the daycare, I noticed they use like a powdered form of something. But yeah, I've still been using this Aquaphor at home, but I've not had any problems, like I said, so far. No diaper rashes, so we're just gonna keep going with this. And the next item on the list, what am I gonna talk about? I'm gonna go with a baby carrier. Definitely, this is the Baby Beyond baby carrier. Yeah, this is mine. So this is definitely a must-have for me, especially when you're by yourself and sometimes you just need your hands free. Maybe you're in the kitchen making dinner and your baby's being fuzzy, they want to be by you. This diaper baby carrier has been a life changer for us, you know, because I just, when Noah is crying and nothing is suiting him, I just pop him on this and he's next to me because there's nothing separating him from my skin. So we have sort of a skin to skin and that kind of suits him and he easily falls asleep. Or maybe in the evening I'm trying to make dinner and he's crying or whatever, I just put it on here and the two of us, we do dinner peacefully. And it's also handy because you can put him on the baby carrier face forward, so he's watching, looking at what you're doing. Or if you want to go do grocery, rather than pushing him in a cart or carrying him in a baby stroller, you just put him here and he's looking along as you guys do the grocery together. It's really so handy. So I would definitely recommend you get yourself a baby carrier, especially if you're alone at home, you know, if you're by yourself. And I mean, like, sometimes you just need to put the baby somewhere, you know, like, and have your hands free so you can do something. Definitely the Baby Beyond baby carrier is the best for me so far, and the quality is so good. It's a little bit pricey, but it's worth it, you know. And it's also easy to put on, you know. It's not so complicated like other baby carriers. You just do it like this and the other side. I'm gonna try to do it on here and you pop it on. Nah, like, not really like that, but it's quite easy to put it on. So get yourself a Baby Beyond carrier. This is a good one. Another item, what am I gonna talk about? Another item on my must, on my baby must haves. I'm gonna talk about, since we are not on the Baby Beyond item, I'll talk about this Baby Beyond baby bouncer. You see, I just got this thing extra just for distractions on it so we can play with it. This thing has been magic. I would say magic, because we started using this when Noah was like 3 weeks old, you know. We just put him in there and kind of bounce him. You can bounce him with your hands or with your foot, you know. You just put it and you bounce it with your foot, and you can be doing something, writing your report or doing some work while your baby is there. Because sometimes just putting a baby to lay down while your hands are free for you to do something, they need help with somebody, with somebody suiting them. And with this Baby Beyond bouncer, I mean, it's the bomb. Honestly, I've been so happy with it. So, and Noah is, we've been using it. I think we're going to use it to, I don't know, what's the age limit? I don't know. But we're going to use it for a long time, I can tell. Yeah. And he has now realized he can bounce himself. So he knows when he pushes on it, it bounces. And he's so happy with that. And you can see him jumping on it. I'm going to put up some videos of him and pictures of him on the Baby Beyond bouncer. Definitely get yourself one of these. It is really, really handy, you know. Like, having a newborn, being a new mom for the first time, sometimes it's really overwhelming. You just need some things to just put the baby, lay them there, and then do some stuff. Come and see me. Sometimes I want to have a shower, and Noah is like, oh, I just put him in here, and I carry him with me to the shower. And now he's there watching while I have my shower, and he's there secured, you know, because sometimes babies just want to see you. They just want to have that eye contact with their mom, and they're fine. So This has definitely been a life changer, and it's also easy, it's portable, you can take it with you wherever. Like, it's not that heavy, and it's very easy to handle, you know. So Baby Beyond Baby Bouncer, it's a must have for me. It's a bit pricey, but there are lots of alternatives out there in the market, so just check. I'm definitely gonna put the link to this one on the description box, but there are sure lots of other alternatives that saves as a baby bouncer on the internet, so get yourself one. The baby's skincare, like for newborns or for babies, you really don't need to be doing much with their skin because it's still very fragile and soft. So what I recommend is like wash them with like a fragrance-free shampoo and a fragrance-free lotion. With Noah, I use the Galenco products. I think that's a European thing. I don't know if you can find it also in the US and in the UK. The Galenco is really good, and I don't have to wash him every day. Like, guys, you really should not wash your baby every day. I know in Africa it's very common for babies to be washed every day. It's not good. It kind of all those chemicals on their skin is really not good. So I wash Noah like once or twice a week since birth, and his skin has been perfect. And also there's some babies who suffer from something, you know, like when they have like a crusty black thing that comes off on their scar. I don't know how that is called though, like just some dark crusty thing, you know, it starts small and then it starts spreading, and if you don't take care of it, it will spread right to their face and sometimes even on their eyebrows. And to prevent that, all you need to do is when you wash them, when you give them their bath, use like a very soft brush. This brush is also I think it just came in the with the Galenco things, I believe. So it's really soft. You just want to gently brush their scalp when you give them a bath. When you gently brush it, that kind of prevents that crustiness and that dry, crusty scalp from happening. A lot of babies do suffer from it. I'm lucky with Noah, I didn't have it, because, I mean, I was really, when I give him his bath, I will gently brush on this and then I'll apply a generous amount of coconut oil on it. Maybe that kind of helps also. But I know like babies that already have it, you can use like the Mustela shampoo. That helps also to get rid of the crustiness and also to help it heal. Because I will maybe look for a picture and pop it there so you guys see what I'm talking about. It can really get bad and it's not good. So protect your baby, give them a bath once or twice a week, and definitely use a soft brush and brush on their scalp when you give them a bath. And start doing this right from birth, you know. Don't think, oh, they're still so young and I will not do that. The sooner you start, the better for you and your baby. So, and another thing that I also wanted to talk about are the bottles that I use for Noah. Oh, they're in the kitchen, all downstairs, but I don't have them here with me. Maybe I'll pop some pictures somewhere. So definitely try and invest in the beginning in good quality bottles. They might be expensive and pricey, but you will use them for a long time. So I got the Philip Avent bottles. They have like different variations of their bottles, but the one I got is like one that you use when you're transitioning from breastfeeding to bottle feeding. So the mouth kind of mimics like the nipple, and it's also made from silicone, so it's soft and it doesn't confuse your baby. So your baby thinks it's still the nipple, though it's a bottle. So definitely invest in a good quality one that will save you. I think buying something that's expensive once is cheaper than having to buy something that is not expensive and then you have to rebuy them because the one you bought got bad and all of that. So, and another must have for me definitely is like a baby camera and the baby phone. Not a lot of people need to use that, but if your baby's room is upstairs and you're most often downstairs, I think you do need a baby camera and a baby phone. Mine is downstairs, so I'll pop a picture when I'm editing the video. That's also a must have. So, and of course, you need to get yourself a good baby stroller and a boogie. That's something, before buying, you really need to do your research on that. Like, know, like, are you living in a city? Are you living in a countryside? Will you be walking a lot with the stroller? So all these things really do come into play. Good. Noah has really been happy with it. What else was I going to talk about? I think that's it. That's it for my must-haves, apart from the bottles that I forgot them downstairs. And also, like, the... What else? Anyway, that's it, guys. That's it for my must-haves. Subscribe and click the notification bell so when I release a new video, you get to see it. And let me know if you love videos like this. You know, being a new mom, I'm definitely learning in the process and sharing what I'm learning with you guys. And also just sitting in the front of the camera and filming, which I love very much. So, if you're new to my channel, I'm Sonjo and I'm a Cameroonian. I live and work in Belgium, married to a Belgian. And we have a newborn called Noah. Is he even a newborn? He's almost 5. I don't think he's still a newborn, right? But yeah, he's changed our life completely. Changed my life completely. Especially my social life. But I'm not complaining. I'm happy with it. He's keeping me busy. So I'm happy with it. So subscribe and share. I hope to see you guys back in my next video.
So we pay so long for so cheap and your flex so deep, sex so deep. You got it, girl, you got it. You got it, girl, you got it. Yeah. Pretty little thing, you got a bag and now you violent. You just took it off the line, no mileage. Waiting in you to be in the group of 17, no guidance. You be staying low, but you know what the price is. Poppin' shit, but only cause you know you poppin', yeah. You